Starting anything can be difficult, especially a business that could completely change your life. With all the moving pieces of any skill set, it takes time and effort to learn how all the components work together, and arguably the most difficult part is the beginning stages and how to get started. That's why in today's video, I'm going to be showing you the most simplistic guide showing you how to go from zero to have a fully functional Shopify dropshipping store by the end of this video. The strategy that I'm going to be teaching you today is not some outdated or BS strategy meant to waste your time. This is how I'm consistently launching winning products and have generated over $5 million through my e-commerce career. And my goal throughout today's video is to teach you how to get every single piece set up. And by the end of the video, not only will you have your very first Shopify dropshipping store live, but you'll also understand how all the components work together. Also, if you guys do get this video to 4,000 likes, I'm gonna be creating a document including 10 winning products that are making thousands of dollars every single day that you can plug and play with the strategy I'm gonna show you. Also, just to show you that this strategy is still working right now, I launched up this store yesterday with the exact strategy that I'm gonna be showing you. And today, it's already at 10 orders for almost $400, and it's only 1 p.m. So we should easily be able to crush the 1K mark today. So with that being said, let's get into the value, and I'm gonna show you how to do everything yourself. Now, I know most of you watching this video know how Shopify dropshipping works, but for anyone new to this business model, I wanna outline each step so you have a crystal clear understanding on how everything functions. Now, dropshipping's a pretty simple process, but in a high-level overview, the process starts with finding different viral products on wholesale Chinese websites, just like AliExpress. Then we can build a super simple website hosted on a point of service, just like Shopify. And we can actually list that product from AliExpress with all the product photos and marketing material they have on our Shopify store. And then we can advertise our business using different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. Then once a customer ends up placing an order from our website, we can go back to that Chinese wholesale website, enter the customer shipping details in, and we get to keep all the profit in between. So essentially you're a middleman in this process, but it can be extremely lucrative, especially when you do this correctly. Now that you understand how this strategy works, there's a few things that you're gonna need to know before you even dive in, like the budget required to get started, how long it's gonna take to see profits, and what's the best strategy to go after. So in a nutshell, I recommend a $500 to $2,000 budget to get started. And while you can do this with a smaller budget, I definitely recommend you have enough capital to rinse and repeat the strategy I'm showing you, because at the end of the day, nothing in life's a guarantee. And especially a business model like this, you're not gonna make millions of dollars off $500. It's gonna take time, effort, and dedication to see this business model out and get sales in your own business. Now, of course, what I'm gonna be showing you is completely accurate and up to date. And if you do follow each and every step I'm gonna be going over today, you're gonna have the absolute highest chance of success. But just make sure you watch this tutorial all the way through and you don't half-ass anything that I'm showing you today. Now, in my opinion, the best and most reliable way to get a profitable dropshipping store off the ground in 2021 is with the one product store approach. This approach is built around the concept of finding only one viral product that solves a real-world problem. A great example of this would be an e-commerce business called Hey Silky Skin. They sell this IPL laser device that you can put on your skin and it removes hair from your body. So essentially the problem that customers are struggling with is unwanted body hair, and Hey Silky Skin is able to promote their product and solve the solution of millions of customers across the world. And that's how they've been able to build this brand into a multi-million dollar lucrative business. And I'm gonna be showing you how to set up this exact same strategy so you can look like a high-end brand just like one of these companies. And it's a more simple process to set up because we only have to worry about one product page and shipping out one product, which just makes everything a lot smoother. Now finally, I'm gonna hop over to my computer and show you the most in-depth tutorial to get your dropshipping store off the ground. So the very first step to be on our way to starting a profitable dropshipping store, and arguably one of the most important parts, is finding a viral and viable product to sell. And in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you two super good methods to find products that are selling right now, so we don't need to validate them on our own, which gives us a much higher chance of success. So the very first method that I'm gonna be showing you today is a completely free method that is so simple. If you have a smartphone, you're gonna be able to do this. So the very first thing you're gonna need to do is you're gonna need to head over to TikTok. TikTok's become this industry leader in e-commerce right now, and by using their platform, we're able to scout dozens of viral products that are selling right now. So what we can do is head over to TikTok, and inside the search bar, we can type hashtag TikTok made me buy it. And what's gonna pop up is tons of different products that have gone viral on TikTok. So if we come over here, let's look at see more. We're gonna go to the hashtag and we can scroll down through these products. And as you see, this post has 3.5 million likes, which is absolutely ridiculous. And we can come over the comments and see how many people are actually interested in this product. So as you can see, there's thousands of people who are claiming that they really want this product, which means that this could likely be a great product to sell. So what I recommend you do is to try to find 10 or 15 product ideas that would be viable. So this is one method, but the next method I'm gonna be showing you is a little bit easier, and definitely easier for beginners to get started.
Oh, you make it sound so easy.
Because this tool is gonna show us Facebook ads that are going viral right now. And if they're going viral, chances are that the competitors are spending a lot of money on the product, which means that they're making a lot of money also. So this tool is called DropySpy, and how we use this tool is come over the filter section over here, and we're able to search by different parameters. So we can come to this section over here and click Shopify in the e-commerce platform section, and then we can come to first seen date, and we're gonna wanna come to the past week, because this is gonna make it so the products that we're seeing are super relevant right now. And then all we need to do is click this search bar over here, and we can come and we can filter by likes, and we can sort them by the ones that have the highest engagement on them, and we can scroll down through these products and see if anything catches our attention. So for example, there's this Father's Day gift over here, and if we click play, it's gonna show us the advertisements which generating all the sales for their store. So I'm gonna leave the link down in the description so you can sign up for this tool, and I recommend you either pick this method or the other method I showed you. There's tons of different product research methods out there. I'll pop another link above if you wanna see a more in-depth product research method. Now, there's one last product research method that I wanted to show you guys. This is something that's never been revealed to the public before, and I'm super excited to show you. I've only had this for some of my top students, but this tool is called Ecom Uplift. Ecom Uplift is a viral product gallery where my team goes out and scours through thousands of different products and picks the top products and delivers everything to you ready-made. So for example, each of these products have descriptions that are ready made for you. We create all these gifts for you and give you guys a really solid chance at having a profitable store without doing anything. And if we keep scrolling down, you can see that we even give you the selling price and the cost of goods for these products. We give you guys Facebook interest that you can go out and test, ready-made Facebook ad copy, and arguably my favorite part of this is when you click this download video button, it's gonna give you a handmade ad that our team's made for each one of these products. So this one for the anti-flea product, you can see that this ad is professionally made and you can use it to test on your own e-commerce store. So each of these videos will cost you about $40 or $50, but these are actually included in each product that's inside of this gallery. Now, I need to be honest with you, there's limited space inside this product gallery because we don't want too many people, otherwise it's gonna saturate the products. So right now I'm letting 40 people into Ecom Uplift. So if you wanna join, you can click the link down in my description, and every single week we're uploading over a dozen products. So this is a really cool and clever way to get dropshipping products off the ground super quickly. But right now you're gonna wanna choose out the product that you're gonna wanna test. And there's a couple criteria that I wanna go over with you so you have the highest chances of being successful when you do choose out your product. So criteria number one, always look at the potential markup of the product. So how you can figure this out is going on AliExpress and finding the exact product that's being advertised on one of these tools. And it's pretty simple to locate these products. Usually what you can do is just search up a few keywords and you should find it pretty simply on AliExpress. If for any reason you're not able to find the product, what I recommend you do is you do a Google image search with some of the product photos that they're using. If for some reason you can't find the product on AliExpress, then one, it's likely not a drop shipping product, and two, you're not searching hard enough because most of the products being advertised on Facebook are drop shipping products unless they have a brand logo on the item or packaging. And once you've located the product on AliExpress, we're gonna wanna keep our eye out for the product price including shipping. So for example, let's say you can get a product for $10 including the shipping price. We're gonna wanna be able to sell that product for $30. So this is what I call the 3x markup rule. You wanna at least be able to sell the product for 3 times the product cost on AliExpress. And how you can determine the sales price is number one, looking at the competitor that's already selling the product. And number two, you could go on Google Shopping and type in your product and see what results pop up and look at other competitors and price your product in the middle. And one thing that I recommend is never price your product too low. A lot of times beginners get into this industry and they try to drop their prices thinking it's gonna get them more sales. But at the end of the day, we need a giant buffer in order for us to pay for the expensive advertising platforms like Facebook or even TikTok advertisements. If we don't have a big buffer, then there's no way that we're gonna be able to acquire customers for our store. And then criteria number two, it has a wow factor or it solves a real world problem. And the reason we choose products that solve real world problems is because we can go on Facebook and tell them that we're looking for a certain demographic of customers, and Facebook will deliver us traffic for what we're trying to target, and they'll be much more inclined to purchase if we show them a product that has a solution for a problem that they're facing in their life. Now, criteria number three, which is a final criteria that I'm gonna be going over today, is product quality. This is very important that we vet products that we're gonna sell before we start selling them, because the worst thing that we could do is we pop a product on our store, it sells like wildfire, and then we figure out it's a terrible product and have to worry about refunds and chargebacks. So one way we can validate the product quality without purchasing the product ourselves is by going on Amazon. Amazon has pretty much every product in the world listed on it. So what we can do is go on Amazon, search some keywords for our product up and see if we can locate the same model of the product. And if we can, then we want to go to that product page and go down to the reviews. There's a few things that we're going to want to be looking at. Number one, the rating overall of the product. So I recommend not selling products with a product rating less than 3.5 stars. And I would also go down to the reviews, read through them and see what the customers are saying, because they're going to be able to give you real feedback. And this way you don't need to spend your own money to try to test it out. You're gonna have data from hundreds or even thousands of customers who have given their feedback on the product already. And if your product passes all these criteria, then congratulations, you're able to move on to the next step. So after you found your product, we're ready to start setting up the bones to create our brand. The very first thing that I recommend you do is to create a domain name, which is gonna be the brand name for your store. So how I usually name these one product stores is super simple. My goal is to make them sound like the originators or creators of the product. So for example, if you're selling a phone charger, you wouldn't want to call it Trend World. You would rather call the store the Simply Charge. And by creating a brand name like this, it's much more trustworthy for the consumer. Plus, we're able to create a real brand. If for any reason you can't think of a domain name, I recommend you come on this website called namemesh.com, and we're gonna be able to put a few different keywords in here and it's gonna populate different domain names we can pick. So for example, if we're selling a phone charger, we could type in easy charger, click generate, and it's gonna populate all these different domain name ideas that we could choose from. So there's gonna be this tab over here called new and then fun. I like looking through this fun fun section because it gives us a really cool idea of different domain names we can use. And after you found one that catches your attention, you could come over to GoDaddy and you're gonna wanna make sure that domain name's actually available. So for example, I'm gonna type in here, Shop Easy Charger. We're gonna click search domain and GoDaddy says this domain name's available, which means it's ready to purchase. Now I don't recommend you purchase your domain name from GoDaddy, but this is just to make sure it's available. If the domain name is available, then we're ready to start creating our logo. A logo used to be super hard and daunting to make. It used to take people a lot of time and a lot of money.
But sometimes it's really hard!
But I'm gonna be showing you a super simple way to get a domain name off the ground for completely free. So how we're gonna accomplish this is with a website called canva.com. Canva is one of the easiest ways to get different design assets off the ground. So you'll be on a website similar to this, and they have all these pre-populated templates for us. So we can click this template called logo. And if you see on the left side over here, they have all these pre-populated logo templates. So for example, let's say we're selling a phone charger. We could come over this computer logo section and we could click one of these over here and we could just put our brand name in. So we could try Easy, and then we could try Charger over here. And then all we need to do is change the font size. So I could drop this down to 15. And as you see, this one doesn't look too good. So we could just click Add Page. So we could try Easy Charger over here, change some of the sizing out, and there you have it. Your logo's all done. I could usually create a logo just like this in about 30 seconds. I can create a solid logo in about 3 minutes. And once you're happy with what you created, you could come over to this download section over here, and you're gonna wanna save it with a transparent background because when we do add it to our website, it's advantageous that we do have a transparent background. So you're gonna need to be subscribed to a pro plan, but if you want to avoid that, go ahead and you could just save it normally. So I'm going to save it as a transparent background over here, click download. And then the next step we're going to want to do with our logo is we're going to want to open this up over here and we're going to want to crop everything out but the logo. So I'm going to click crop and there you have it. Your logo is ready to enter on your website. All right, so now that your logo is ready to go, we're ready to get started on our Shopify store. So the very first thing you're gonna wanna do is start a free 14-day trial. So you can just head over to shopify.com to accomplish this. And once you've done that, you should be on a page just like me right now. So this is gonna be the back end of your Shopify store. And this is where all of our orders come through. We're able to list our products and design our website. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do once we get to this page is we're gonna wanna come over this online store section. Inside this online store is where we're able to host our Shopify theme. The theme is what controls the design of our website, and how we can pick a theme out is by coming over here and coming to this free theme section. You can choose a paid theme, but I recommend as a beginner to pick a free theme because it's gonna be a really simple way to get off the ground. And some of the free themes that I recommend are this Boundless theme. I've used this on one of my seven-figure stores before, and then Debut's a good theme, and then Brooklyn's also a good theme. So for today's video, I'm just gonna be using the standard Debut theme over here. So you can just click close because the Debut will already be installed in your store. And you're gonna wanna scroll up and you're gonna wanna come to this customize section. When you click inside this customize section, this is where it's gonna host our entire website. So as you see, you're gonna be on a page just like this right now. Now the first thing we're gonna wanna do is come over this header section, and we're gonna wanna come over and we're gonna wanna upload the logo that we created. So you can just upload your logo and it will show right here, and we can just click select, and then we can come back here, and if we wanna change the logo sizing, we could play with the width over here. Now there's nothing more that we're gonna wanna do in this section. We're not gonna wanna change the main menu over here because we haven't set our navigation tab up. I'm gonna show you guys how to do that in a moment. But what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna set up an announcement bar over here. So when you click this show announcement, you should see this show up. It's gonna say announce something here. And here's where we can point to any promotions that we're running. So ideally, when you are running advertisements on your e-commerce business, you wanna point to some type of promotion that you're running, because this will make it so your customers are more inclined to make a purchase. So for example, if you wanna let your customers know that you have 30% off the products that you're selling, then you could just type in here 30% off until Tuesday. So this will let customers know that there is items on sale. And then once you do that, you could change the color scheme if you want. So over here, you can see that I have this blue color scheme over here. You can come back to the logo you made on Canva to try to find the color you use. So I'm gonna click this blue box. We're gonna come over the color over here and click this plus sign, and it's gonna give us the exact color code. So we can copy this, come back to our Shopify store, and we can type this in the bar section. And as you see, this color will change into the new color that we just picked. So as you can see, now our color scheme is congruent. This is something that I really recommend you to do, because at the end of the day, we don't wanna use too many colors because it's gonna make our store look unprofessional. So make sure you stick to only one or two colors at most. Now, what you can do is save your product page over here. This is gonna make sure that everything we built doesn't get deleted. Make sure every few minutes or so you're saving your page. The worst thing that you could do is put a ton of work in and everything gets deleted. Now, once you've done that, let's come back over to this section over here, and we're gonna click image with text overlay. So this is gonna control this whole section over here. And what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna find an aesthetic image that we can put inside this section. So one way you can find high quality and professional photos to put inside your store is by clicking inside of here and using their free image tab. So luckily Shopify does provide us with some stuff. So I can just type in here phone, and let's see if it has anything for phone chargers. So as you can see, there's this guy using a phone over here. So we could choose this image and click select. If you don't find any images that you like right here, you could go on a website called pexels.com, or you could look for high quality images on AliExpress for the exact product you're selling. Sometimes you won't find high quality photos on AliExpress, so this would be your second choice if you don't find that. Now, once your image is entered in, we're gonna wanna scroll down here and come to this heading section that says image with text overlay. And in this section, we wanna provide a quick sentence that's gonna catch their attention about your product. So for today's example, I'm gonna be building the store around a phone charger. So we can say upgrade your phone charger. Something really simple that catches their attention and makes them know what they're shopping with today. Now, you're gonna wanna scroll down to this text section over here, because this is gonna be another sentence that relates to this header. So we could just say the fastest and most functional phone charger on the market. Something really simple like that. And then inside this button label section, we're just gonna type shop now. And then inside this button link, we wanna direct it to the product page, but we haven't created our product page yet. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna click this section, come over to products. And once the product's added, which I'll show you guys how to do in just a second, it will populate right here and you can just click that. And it's gonna make sure that this button directs them to the right page. Now, after you've done that, let's go back and come to this section. So there's a few things I'm gonna want you to do. I'm gonna want you to delete this section over here. So we could just scroll down, click remove section. And we're gonna wanna do this with featured collection as well. And then we're gonna wanna do this with testimonial, image with text overlay. And then last but not least, we're gonna wanna do it with the gallery. And then all we're gonna wanna do over here is click add section. And we're gonna wanna add another image with text section. So right here, we're gonna wanna click select. And then you're gonna wanna click right as the image alignment so it looks much more congruent when you scroll down. Now, the reason why we deleted all those pre-populated templates is because with one product stores, you don't need that much information on the homepage. Most of the selling is gonna be done on the product page, but I'm still gonna show you how to set up this homepage. So the next thing we're gonna wanna do now is we're gonna wanna go back over to AliExpress where all the product photos for our product are located. Now, once you're on the AliExpress product page, you're gonna wanna download a Chrome extension called AliSave, because with one button, we can download all the photos for this product. So we can just click this button over here and it's gonna download each one of these products. So what we can do now is we can come back over to our store and we can come into one of these image with text sections and we can upload one of these photos, just drag them in here, and we can try to find the high quality photo that we can use inside this section. So in my opinion, this isn't my favorite photo, so we could just remove it and we could try one of these other images out. So let's see if this one looks decent. And I actually like this one a lot better. So what we can do now is we can scroll down to this heading section and we want to create a heading that relates with this product photo. So this saying that this 360 degrees chargeable. So what we could say here in the heading is charges all your devices. And inside this text section, we can say with our 360 degree charging technology, you can feel free knowing that all your devices will be ready for a full day of use. So there you have it, a really simple text section over here. You don't need to overcomplicate it in the home page. And then you're gonna wanna scroll down and you're gonna wanna rinse and repeat what we did in this section with another product photo. And you're gonna wanna put another informative heading and another informative sentence so they learn a little bit more about your product. Now, once you've done that, you wanna come back and you wanna click add section. And there's gonna be one last thing that we're gonna wanna add here, which is gonna be a place that they can buy your product. So we can scroll down and we can click featured product and click select. And since we don't have our product added to the website, you can't enter this in yet. I probably should have showed you guys how to add the product first, but I'm gonna show you guys that right now. So once you do this, you can just come back to this section and upload the product photo here and change the link out in this section. Now, the last thing that I wanna show you guys on how to design this storefront is to go inside theme sections. And then you're gonna wanna come to theme settings over here, and you're gonna wanna make sure your color scheme's congruent. So we're gonna wanna change the buttons up so it matches the blue color scheme that we chose. And then one more thing that you're gonna wanna do is come over this checkout, and we're gonna need to upload the logo that we created into the checkout page. And we're gonna wanna change the button to the color scheme we're using. So just scroll down, choose our color scheme over here, and the homepage should be pretty much done. This is a pretty simple version of a homepage, but I made tons of tutorials showing you guys something a little bit more complex. And if you guys wanna learn how I design my stores click by click, then you guys can always sign up for my program. It's a super reasonable price. So I'll leave that link down in the description. But after you got your homepage ready and set up, you can just click save, and we're gonna wanna click this exit button. So it's gonna take us back to our Shopify storefront, and we're gonna wanna come over this product section over here. So inside this product section is where all the products that we choose are gonna be listed. But one way we can import our products and make this process a little bit more simple is coming over this app section, coming to explore apps, and then just typing in here Oberlo. Oberlo is a tool that will automatically import the product to our website. So we can just click add app, and then just make sure you click this install app section. And then we're just gonna need to create an account for Oberlo. It's pretty simple, just enter an email in over here. And then once you've actually done that, make sure to click create free account, and it's gonna get everything set up for us. And the next thing we're gonna wanna do is come over this import list over here. We're gonna wanna click add products by URL or ID, and we're gonna wanna go to the AliExpress product page that we're using for our product. We're gonna wanna come over and paste this in the product ID and click add product. And then this product's gonna populate on Oberlo, and we're gonna be able to do a few things. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna change this product title out. So we could say over here, the 3-in-1 wireless charger. And then we don't need to do anything over here. We don't need to worry about collections type or any tags, but we're gonna wanna come over this product description section. And we're gonna wanna make sure we remove all of this, because this is the standard AliExpress stock text that's gonna come over. And trust me, we don't wanna use that. It's not gonna convince customers to buy. So let's delete that. And we're gonna wanna come over the variant section. And this is really important that we make sure that both of these variants are integrated into our store. Because if customers wanna choose a black variant, they're gonna be able to do that, or they're gonna be able to choose white. So now the next thing we're gonna wanna do is come over this price over here, because this is gonna determine what price our product sold at. So how we can determine this, like I mentioned in the product research method, is 3 times the product cost. So if you see over here, our product's $24 with $2.33 shipping. So ideally you would wanna sell this product for around $74.99. Usually you wanna round up to the nearest 99 cents, because that's kind of industry standard when you do sell retail products, and you're just gonna copy this and you're gonna paste it over here. Now, if you come over to this profit section, you can see that we're able to profit $48 every time someone orders, but there's one last thing we're gonna wanna do, and it's gonna be in this compare app price. So like I mentioned, when you're creating the announcement bar and putting a promotion inside your website, this is gonna be another way that you can tell customers that there's a good deal happening. So for example, if your product's $74.99 right now, what you can do is say that the product used to be $99, and you could say that your website's 25% off right now. So it's pretty much what all retailers do. They give you some type of discount to make it seem like it's a better deal. Now, once you've done that, we can do one last step, which is come over this image section, and we can just click the images that we wanna use in our product section. So just click any high quality photos that you wanna use. So I found all the photos that I wanna use, and then we're just gonna click import to store, and this is gonna make sure that all the product photos get delivered into our storefront. And after a few seconds, the product will be ready to go. So we can just click edit product on Shopify. And this is gonna take us to the exact product on Shopify. So you can see 3-in-1 wireless charger over here. And if we come over this preview section, it will show us our exact storefront and what we have ready to go right now. So you can see that we are missing a product description. This, in my opinion, will make or break your e-commerce store, because if you don't have a good product description, then no one's gonna wanna buy from you. So I'm gonna show you an example of some of the product descriptions we use on our e-commerce store with the tool Ecom Uplift I showed you guys before. So if we come over here, these are the ready-made product descriptions that you can actually get if you do sign up for this product description tool. So we can scroll down and we can actually copy all of this information over here, and then we can actually paste it inside that section. So I'm gonna copy it, I'm gonna paste it over here, and I know this is a different product. This isn't the same product we're selling, but this is gonna give you guys an idea of the product descriptions you wanna create. So ideally over here, you would have one paragraph about the product and why people are actually gonna be interested in it, and make sure that you're trying to solve their problem and think about different reasons they would be enticed with your product. And then what we found to be very effective is posting different GIFs with the product in use over here. It increases your conversion rate quite a bit. Now, if you scroll down, I love to put a specification section over here with a few different bullet points about why the product's gonna be useful to them. And then a little paragraph in each one of these bullets. So you can see this one's 100% natural and hypoallergenic, helps stop fleas and ticks, sustained release technology, easy to use, year-round care, and comfortable and waterproof. And then I like to put another GIF over here so you can show this GIF is actually removing the ticks from them. So I think this is a really effective graphic. And then there's just another paragraph over here. And I like to incorporate a lot of different images inside the product description, because people are very visual when they're shopping online. And this is gonna definitely make it so customers are more inclined to purchase. Now, you guys can definitely use this exact template in your own product descriptions, because this has been proven over millions of dollars in sales for this exact template. So definitely take it from me. And if you guys wanna sign up for Ecom Uplift and have ready-made product descriptions for you, then the link is down below. But once you have this in, just click save and we can press preview again and we can see the product descriptions in here. So what I would do is I would remove a few spaces over here. So you can see that this is a pretty solid and effective product description. Now, the next thing we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna put some reviews into our e-commerce store. My favorite review app on the market is Ryviu, so R-Y-V-I-U. So you can just come back to the app store, you can type it in explore apps, and then what you're gonna be able to do is you're gonna be able to import all of the reviews on AliExpress into your exact product page, so it's not gonna look like you're a new brand that just came off the ground. This is what pretty much everyone does when they start an e-commerce business, so it doesn't look like they just popped up overnight. So now there's a few more things that we're gonna wanna get set up. So we're gonna wanna come over this online store over here. We're gonna wanna come over to pages, and we're gonna wanna add a few different pages to our website. Number one, we're gonna wanna add a contact us page. We're gonna wanna add a track order page, a refund policy page, a privacy policy page. And I show you guys how to do this on my free course that I actually listed. So I don't don't want to go over that again, but I will leave a link above. You guys should definitely check that video out because this is going to be similar to this video, but almost on steroids. So definitely check that video out because I'm also going to be showing you guys the complete advertising strategy, like how to set up your Facebook page, how to get Facebook ads set up off the ground. I don't like to be too repetitive in my videos, so I'm not going to be going over that in today's video, but make sure to check that out if you guys want to take the next step, because I just wanted to show you how to start Shopify dropshipping today. But if you guys want to learn with my free course, definitely check it out. All right, guys, so my camera just died, but that was pretty much everything that I had set out for you guys. But I wanted to tell you that, to be honest, this one video is just not going to be enough. You guys are going to have to browse a lot of my other videos, like the free course I mentioned, in order to have a full understanding. Watching a 30-minute video isn't going to help you create a $1 million business. So just make sure that you go out there with some tenacity and keep rinsing and repeating the strategies I'm giving you, and make sure you're educating yourself so you can get your business off the ground. Anyways, I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like and subscribe to the channel. But I'll see you guys in my next video very soon. Take care and peace out.